have come up to make you a star performer in solving this most important problem today. If you follow these videos, you will see improvement gradually. It will not happen instantly, but eventually it will happen. So here is the problem from numerical solutions of ordinary differential equations. Using Runge-Kutta method or RK method of second order, we have to compute y at 0.5 from dy by dx is equal to x plus y by x, where x of y of 2 is equal to 2, taking h is equal to 0.25. And here it is given that dy by dx is equal to x plus y by x. So which we have to consider as the function in x comma y is equal to x plus y by x. And it is also given at y at 2 is equal to 2, which means y naught is equal to 2 and x naught is equal to 2. And here h value is given as 0.25. Now we have to use Runge-Kutta method or RK method. So according to the Runge-Kutta second order method, this is Runge-Kutta method of second order. So according to the second order, see the formula here is y1 is equal to, this is y0 plus half times of, this is k1 plus k2. So what is this k1 and k2? We have to find the value of k1 using this formula, that is k1 is equal to h times of, this is f of x0, this is y0, and k2 value will get according to the formula h times of f of x0 plus h, and this is y0 plus again k1. So we have to use this value. So using this one, according to RK method of second order, we have to substitute all this value. So in order to use this, first we have to find k1 as well as k2. So what is k1 here? K1 is equal to h times of f of x0, y0. All the values are ready here. So here I am writing once again, that is x0 is equal to 2, y0 is equal to 2. See, our h value is 0.25. So if I apply here, h value is 0.25 and f of, what is x0? This is 2 and y0, this is 2. And according to our function, that is f of x comma y is equal to x plus y by x. So k1 is equal to, this is 0.25 into x plus y by x. So k1 value is equal to, this is 0.25 by here, that is the 4 by 2. That is 4 by 2, which is equal to 2. So k1 is equal to 0.50. So I got the value of k1. So now I have to check the value of k2 or calculate the value of k2. That is h times of f of x0 plus h, y0 plus, this is k1. See here, our k2 value is equal to, what is h? That is 0.25. This is 0.25 and f of, what is x0? x0 value is 2. This is 2 plus h. h is 0.25. What is our y0? y0 is 2. And again our k0 value is 0.5. So our k0 value is equal to 0.25 into f of, this is 2.25 and this is 2.5. And according to our function, we have, I'm writing once again, f of x comma y is nothing but, this is x plus y by x. So k2 value is equal to, this is 0.25, this is 2.25 plus 2.5 by x, this is 2.25 again. That is k2 is equal to, see here, this is 2.25 plus 2.5 divided by 2.25 into 0.25. The value here is 0.5277. So we got the values of k2 as well as k1. After getting k2 and k1, so we have to, after getting k1 and k2 value, we have to substitute in this formula, that is y1 is equal to, this is y0 plus h times of, see here, I have to substitute here, that is y1 is equal to y0 plus half times of, this is k1 plus k2. So y1 is equal to, what is y0 value? So y0 it is 2. I am writing here y0 it is 2. And what is our k1 value here? So k1 value is 0.5. See here, our k1 value is 0.5 and k2 value is 0.5277. So if I substitute here, this will be 2 plus half times of k1 is 0.5 plus 0.5277. So if I add up all these, 0.5 plus 0.5277 divided by 2, this is plus 2. The value here it is. See the value here. So we got the value of y1 as 2.5. See, this is 2.514. Therefore, so y1 is equal to, this is 2.514. If I correct to two decimals. So this is our initial value, and we have to apply the second step. According to the second step, see. So we have to make two steps minimum, and the second step for that. So we got y1 is equal to 2.514 and x0. So initially x0 value is 2. So we have x0 value as 2. And therefore x1 is equal to x0 plus h. So see here, our x1 is equal to, what is x0? This is 2 plus h value is 0.25. h value is 0.25. I'll show you, it's here. So if I add this, our next value is 2.25. So I got the value of x1 as 2.25. h value is this is 0.25. so h value is 0.25. after getting all these values, we have to use the second step. So again, for the second step, we have, see, same, we have to change this. So here it is y1, so we have to find y2 value. So y2 will be wherever you find y0, we have to start with y1. So this is half 1 by 2 times of, this is k1 plus k2. This is k1 plus k2. So now we want the value of k1. So here k1 is h times of f of x0 y0. Here we have to write as h times of f of x1 y1. So k2 value is, see here, our k2 value is h times of, this is f of, here we have to write x1 plus h comma y1 plus, again this is k1. So in this formula, if we apply, then we'll get the value of y2. See here, let's start with k1. So here our k1 value is h times of f of x1 y1. So all the x1, y1, h all are ready here. That is, h is equal to, what is h? 0.25. and what is x1? This is 2.25, and y1 value is 2.514. So k1 is equal to, this is 0.25, and f of x comma y is nothing but, according to the question, it is x plus y by x. So this is x and this is y. This is x plus, this is y by, this is x. So now if I calculate, see, this is 2.25 plus 2.514 divided by 2.25 into 0.25. So the answer here is 0.529. So k1 value is 0.5293. I got the value of k1. So next I have to go with k2 value. So k2 value is nothing but, see here the formula, this is h times of f of x1 plus h. This is y1 plus k1. This is y1 plus k1. So after finding this k2 value, I'll substitute in the above formula. Then k2 value is equal to, what is our h value? So h is 0.25. so this is 0.25 into f of x1. So what is our x1 value? This is 2.25 plus h. h is 0.25. this is 0.25. and what is our y1? y1 is 2.514 plus, what is our k1 value? This is 0.5293. therefore k2 is equal to 0.25 into f of, this is 2.25 plus 0.25, this is 2.5 comma, this is 2.514 plus 0.5293. this value is 3.0433. So this value is 0.25 into x plus y by x. This is x plus 3.0433 by this is 2.5. So let's check here. 2.5 plus 3.0433 divided by this is 2.5 into 0.25. Therefore, our k2 value is 0.555 into 33. So after getting k1 and k2 value, so we have to substitute in this formula, that is y2 is equal to, see, y2 is equal to y1 plus half times of k1 plus k2. So if I substitute, then y2 value is, what is y1? So y1 value is 2.514. This is 2.514 plus half times of k1. What is k1 value? That is 0.5293 plus k2. This is 0.55433. So if I substitute here, this is 0.5293 plus 0.55433 divided by 2 plus, see here, this is 2.514. The answer is 3.0558. That is 3.0, this is 558. This value is y2. So according to our Runge Gupta second order method, we got the final value of y as, this is 3.0558. So this is how we have to solve. Just RK method, it is the most important method. So using RK method, it will, so it is mentioned in the question that it is used to mention in the question that we have to use the second order. So this is the second order formulae, and later I'll be uploading about the fourth order and third order also. So here the function is x comma y is given as x plus y by x, and we have to write from this equation as y naught is equal to 2 and x naught is equal to 2 and y naught is equal to 2, and h value is given as 0.25, and all the values are ready. And according to the RK method, Runge Kutta method of second order, we have to find y1 is equal to y naught plus half times of k1 plus k2. Initially we have to find the value of k1 using this formula and k2 using this formula. So every value is ready, x naught, y naught, h, every value is ready here. After substituting every value, I got the value of k1 as well as k2. Now I have to substitute in this formula to get the value of y1. So after getting y1 value, so we have to see the second step. So again, y1 is ready, x1 is nothing but x0 plus h, x1 is also ready, and again we have to find k1 and k2, and we have to place in this formula in order to get the y2 value. So this is the final answer. This is how we have to solve. It's very simple. If you follow, everything CALCI will operate. And that's all for today. And there are going to be many more videos coming up in this series. Thank you for pulling out all your time, staying all through my journey. And really, if you like, please raise your thumb, share it with your friends, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much.